Hello, it's Keith from KMAs Korner. I am back on the Serenity server with my mustachio. Let me take this off. See my crossbars on my person? Doesn't that look like a mustache almost? I noticed that the other day when I was editing a video. But today, I am cutting down tons and tons of birch because I am making a building that uses... Hi guy, you're gonna get mad at me in a minute, so I might as well kill you now. I am making a building that uses tons and tons of birch, and I've already used about 20 stacks of it. I showed you a little bit of the building in the background there. And I'm gonna need probably another 30 or 40 stacks. Ooh. But seeing that this is the Serenity server, I think the best building I could possibly build is a pagoda. So that is what I'm building. And I overestimated the amount of wood, or underestimated the amount of wood I'm gonna need for this project. And that's what usually happens with Minecraft, is you have a project in mind thinking, oh yeah, this is gonna take an hour or two, maybe three, and then after 10 stacks of wood or logs, and 4 hours later you have the first floor done and there's 7 floors, you go, oh, I've got myself in a little deeper than I think I should. Well, let me go and, I put hat slabs in here so nothing spawns. Come on, give me ender pearl. Thank you, no ender pearl. There's gonna be stuff in here. Don't worry, it's not gonna be a wide open area. I had a little creeper problem. He blasted away some of my fences. But this is the size of the thing, and it's a lot more intensive than I had thought. So, yeah. I think, though, it will look good. So there's a floor here. There's going to be 5 or 6 more floors on top of it, and each floor is going to be a little bit smaller. So I'm going to, you know, do what I've been doing for the last few hours, which is keep mining wood. I need a skeleton spawner. There is a spawner on the server somewhere, but I don't want to harass the guy and say, hey, how much for a double chest of bones? Because it would be a lot easier to be able to just grow these trees instead of waiting for them to grow. But I don't have a lot of diamonds. As a matter of fact, I don't think I have any diamonds left, and that's the main currency that you would use to buy stuff from other people. So not only do I have to get a shit ton, excuse the word, of bone meal or these trees, I gotta get a shit ton of mining done also. Which is actually, I just read Hal, who is the server man on this server, he called this place Serenity because he enjoys just strip mining and stuff. And it's kind of funny, probably a month ago in one of my videos, I went and talked extensively on how part of the reason why I like Minecraft so much is mining, because it's so relaxing for me. So I'm glad I'm not the only person. So, oh, and one more thing before I go. The views on this series have been incredible. So incredible that I've even thought that maybe I've been view-botted. But both of the videos I've made on this server have, the views are just amazing. So I really, really appreciate that. Keep it up. The more views I get, the better. I can't really say that. I was going to say, the more views I get, the better inspiration. But it's not going to really change the amount of, or the type of content I have. But it will, I don't know. I just really appreciate the views. It really means a lot. It motivates me to make more videos on Serenity, even though this was kind of like a stepping stone server while I wait to be accepted into another one where I can play with one of my friends on a regular basis, and that's just taking its time. But now I don't know, because this series has taken off, and I don't want to take away a series that is doing well and a series I do enjoy making. So I'm gonna continue doing this again for the 10th time, and I'll get back to you when a little bit more is built. Hello, I am back. I have done some exterior design to the pagoda, and there it is, not all its wondrous birch beauty. A lot of birch. There's not much contrasting colors right now because I haven't added any, but I'll tell you what, this thing has taken me a very long time to do. And I have cut down so many birch trees over here. As you see, I plant them over here. I made a little birch forest. This is actually supposed to be kind of like a plains biome. What is this? It is a plains biome. So no birches allowed. So when I'm done with this building, all these birch trees are go. There are some trees over here, but for the most part, all the birch trees are gonna go. And one of the reasons why I wanted to make a pagoda, I'm obviously gonna have staircases going up right now. I can't even get up there unless I make scaffolding. But one of the reasons why I wanted to make a pagoda is I've always wondered how to make these corner pieces. And I've made a whole bunch of them. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So I've made 20 of them in this building alone. And I think I'm gonna show you real quick how to do it before I start working on the inside of this building. So let me get a couple of supplies and I'll show you how to make one of those corner pieces if you ever wanna try doing a pagoda. So, let's just say, 1, 2, 3, 4. Say this is a corner of your normal building roof, okay? And this corner is the corner that you want to add one of those funky little things on the side. So you expand two out on the corners here. Then you put a stair there. You put a stair there. Then what you do is get rid of the block underneath the stair, and what I do is put a block above the hole in the middle of the stair. And in this particular thing, you see the glowstone would go right there. So let's use this as glowstone because I don't have silk touch and I don't want to waste any glowstone. So that would be the glowstone. So that is the corner. It's pretty easy to do. So if you ever wanted to make a pagoda and this is the right scale for it, that's what you want to do. So now that I'm not gonna crush this down, now that this is all made, let me get far away so you can actually see the top of it. Yeah, that thing's a lot bigger than I wanted. And being up at the top, and I almost fell down once. You're very high up there. But now that the exterior is made, I'm going to have to make it look interesting. And the other blocks that I'm going to cut it with to make it interesting is I am going full out, yes, diorite. So diorite is going to be the foundations to hold up the insides and separate the rooms in here. And where you would normally see the white cloth covering where windows would be in the pagoda, I am gonna be using blue glass. I think it's gonna be blue. I don't know if I want to waste all my lapis on it, so I might make it like a magenta and spam the flowers here to get the magenta color, but we'll see. I have a whole bunch of glass or sand being smelted into glass right now. And as you notice, I on the server, if it gets dark and somebody jumps into a bed, If you type okay and more than 50% of the people say okay, it will turn it to daytime. Pretty cool thing about the server. It's why it's not 100% vanilla, but it's, you know, close enough. So there's my update on the building. This took me 4 or 5 hours to do, but it's done. And I'm sorry, guys, I've killed a couple hundred of you. I've probably used 12, 15 stacks of logs on here. So there's fences and stairs. There's lots of stairs in there too. I'll stop whining. It was fun. There's 9 to 13 people on last night. And just, you know, chatting with the people on the server while doing this is a little bit more exciting than just being on a single server world. Or a single player world. So, I'm gonna wait for the glass to smelt and I'm gonna start building the inside. And I'll let you know what it looks like when it's partially done. Probably not done, but partially done at least. I want to get this whole building done by the end of the video. Now that I said that, that's definitely not going to happen, but that is my goal. I want to finish this building before the end of the video. So I got some work to do. I gotta go. Good morning, I am back. I have done a little bit more work to the pagoda. I finished the other floors, and I started building the groundwork for the beams and stuff, where everything's gonna be coming from. And I'm kind of regretting my choice of birch wood right now, but I think I'm gonna still try and make this work. I may have to take out the diorite. It really all depends. I should get a partial blue wall up, because in between these pylons is gonna be blocks, and those blocks are going to define what this building looks like. But let me show you what I've done. I'm figuring out the stairway right now. And so this isn't going to actually happen. It's not... It looks fine, but aesthetically it doesn't work with these pylons. So I'm going to have to find out where I'm going to end up putting the stairway and how I'm gonna do it, because that doesn't really look too good. So it just ignored the stairway, and I kind of made it also, or completed it, because working on these top floors and pillaring up outside was quite the pain in the butt. So this is the second to top floor, what it looks like. And this one is not actually gonna have a stairway. It's gonna be some sort of ladder going up, because it's too small up here. But that's not gonna be the placement of the ladder either. And there's the top. Kind of run out of food with this project because it's been so long, and I haven't been beating my farm animals because they're way over... I always get turned around in this... way over there somewhere. And I was using my... I had a bunch of iron, and I used about 4 or 5 iron... axes, normal axes to cut wood, and I'm like, screw this, I'm so sick of breaking my iron tools, I might as well just go and do a 30 level enchant on a diamond axe, which I only got silk touch. I saw the silk touch and I'm like, yeah, I don't know if I want silk touch on an axe, but I still went through it because I only had 30 levels at the time, and I didn't want to waste a level to change up the enchant. And I figured with Silk Touch I'd get something, at least efficiency or something on there. And so I decided to go caving instead to get some diamonds, because I was all out of diamonds, and as you see I do have some diamonds now. And with the efficiency 5 fortune 3 pick, caving is good. So I was able to get a lot of coal and all the necessary resources that I needed, and some diamonds, and yes, I'm leading the race on diamonds on the server for the week, for the past 7 days. That's what it is. They have a diamond counter for the past 7 days on the server, and I'm beating everybody right now. Come knock me off the hill, guys, because even if you get more than me, I am gonna try my best to get more than you. It's a little competition I'll have with you. So but on my path, the reason why there isn't more done with this build is on my path to getting product and diamonds, I ran into something kind of amazing, which kind of stopped me in my tracks. And let me go show you that right now. You see way in the distance over there, that pillar right there, that marks a cave spider and my other spider farm entrance. So I have two spider farms right there, and then they're completed and ready to go, as you saw in the last video. But while caving, I came down here, and of course, because I need more spider stuff, we get the another spider spawner, which is great and all, and I don't, you know, I still need to clear out these caves, but usually when I find a spider spawner, I try and get out of range so it turns off. See that? And build a stair. Ah, stupid cobwebs. And build a ladder chute up so I know exactly where the spawner is. So if I want to make something out of it one day, I will. But that isn't the amazing thing. Even though there's three spider spawners in this little area, I found something else that was even more amazing. And I'm not going to do it this episode, but I am going to do a whole episode on this. But I gotta do some research and figure out the best way to tackle this situation. Oh, hi. Here. I gotta get... You're spazzing out, man. You're spazzing out. Carrots are not drugs. Carrots are not drugs, I tell you. I considered this area very beautiful, very serene, and it, like... kind of sums up what Serenity is to me, because it's a flower forest and it's just awesome. So I said, wow, that's where I'm going to build my pagoda. Nice, nice area to do that. And maybe make a couple of flower farms here. And, but underneath is something very evil. Very awesome, but very evil. Amazing. So what's amazing? I got four spider spawners in the little area. But that's not the real amazing thing about this. I have that one. Look at that. There's one right there. And if you see, I can stand here. That one's activated. And that one's activated. And I should light this up. Don't need any mobs spawning down here while I'm working. But that's not even the real amazing thing about it. So as I stand here and activate that one and that one, there's a third one right there. So, this is going to be the massive spider spawn. The hellish thing underneath my beautiful pagoda. I'm going to have to call this Spidey Land or Spider Land or something. I have never ever seen two spider spawners. It's one, two, three blocks away from each other. Are you kidding me? So, obviously, I'm gonna have to do something about that. So yeah, that is gonna be next episode. I'm gonna make even a third different type of spider, because you can't be doing... Let's see how close I can get. There we go. Yeah, I'm gonna have to make a little AFK room and a third type of spider spawner, because I made the one for the big spiders, the two wide spiders, and I showed you that in the last episode, and I showed you what to do with the cave spiders. And this one, I am at level 38, so if I drop a 28, 30 levels, I'm gonna be just below where I don't like to dig any deeper, which is 11. But I am gonna make probably a gravity killing spawner out of these three. But I just needed to show you that. That's why my building was completely stopped, and it's not completed yet. But I'm gonna work on that a little bit more, and I will get back with you guys. I just needed to show you that. And if you have any ideas of what I should do if you don't think the gravity thing is. I'm not 100% sure if I'm going to do the gravity drop and collect the goods with the rail hoppers and rail carts, because I don't really want to waste hoppers. Hoppers are expensive, and I'm just beginning out in the world, and I don't have a ton of iron. But I have access to it, because I have two mine shafts, or abandoned tunnels, that I haven't looted yet, that I've lit up, that has a ton of iron. But give me an ideas on what to do with these spider spawners, because I do need to make something awesome. So, I have officially become the world wool maker for everybody, especially when this is done. And I have also reached a level where I can build at spawn on the server. So, that is what I'm gonna do.
Alright guys, I am back. I was unable to do more work on the building because I kept on needing supplies and stuff. And everywhere I go, I have abandoned mine shafts. And so I needed to show you this also. We got another spider spawner here. I sound so depressed when I say that. The only reason why I say that is because I really wanted to get this building done for this episode, but I've been distracted so much by these dang spider spawners. But guess what? There's one. And there's another. And as you see, another place where I can get more than one spider spawner. Connected. So that makes 5, 6, 7, 8 spider spawners within 100 block radius of each other. So this world, how do I get out of here? This world is gonna be called Spidey Land because I have the two here that I can stand at together. There's one there. There's one there. Not gonna make that. And there's another one back there. I can't really see it from here. Let me get up here. Oh. But first, let me take care of a little business. So yeah, there's one there, one there. One there, two there, then of course, ooh, I'm not gonna make that jump. We cross over this river. Is there another river? Oh, we cross over another river. La la da da. So with all of those other spider spawners, we have 2, 3, 4, 5, and I showed you this in the last clip, but gotta refresh my own memory. There's 6, 7, and 8. And there are two more that I have no idea where they are. So, and then I run into them and I decided, you know, screw it. I'm not gonna mark them right now. So what I think I'm gonna do is get a haste beacon in here, destroy every block that's in this area, make a huge cavern, so I can see all the spider spawners and figure out what the hell I'm gonna do with them. Because obviously my Serenity, my chill world that I want to relax at, has now turned to Spider Land with lots of spiders. And I heard a skeleton. I thought it was up here. So my flower farm, my beautiful chill place where I was going to make a nice little lake home right here, it's turned into a hellish spider world where I am just going to be known as Mr. Spider. But in the middle of doing all that, I finished the first floor completely, I believe completely. I added the blue glass because that was the big thing I wanted to do. And now I am kind of upset that I used birch wood. I want to replace all this birch wood with a darker wood because this is not looking the way I thought it would. No pun on wood. But I don't know. That's going to take forever and a day. This build has already taken me 10 to 12 hours of real lifetime. And to replace this wood, which is a main structure, is going to take a good 5 hours of my time also. And I don't know if I'm going to worry about that. So it may just stay birch. But on the inside, I made this. This is actually based on a design that was made a few years ago by a guy named Matthias. He made a pagoda, and the shell is designed like his, kinda. And the basic interior design so far is based on what he was doing, with a little changes, because when he was doing the Minecraft, there was no stairs and whatever. You could, when you had to place fences, I don't know if people remember this, you couldn't just like place a fence. Let me get a fence. You couldn't just place a fence right there like that. What you had to do when fences first came out, you had to place a block, and kind of like jack-o'-lanterns or pumpkins, then you'd place it, then you could get rid of the block. So it was a little different back then. But Minecraft has changed a lot. When I first started playing, they just began the Nether, so it was a long time. There is a monster in my house? That's where you are. Come down. I thought this place was monster-proof. Come on. Where are you? Oh, that's why. I started making the platforms for the second floor and haven't added any glowstone to it yet. So yeah, this building is a work in progress. There'll be something so I don't fall off the stairs there too. And I hope you like the blue glass. And obviously, where you see the glass hanging like this, there's actually going to be wood down here. I'm going to be getting rid of these bottom pieces and replacing them with wood also. Because I don't really care for what that looks like. So it would be more like that instead of that. So, you know, it's a work in progress. So those wood pieces will be gone. I mean, not wood, those diorite pieces will be gone. And I added some glass up here. I'm going to end up taking away from this level up and rebuilding it and adding an extra floor. So that would be coming up. I don't know if I'm going to do that in the next episode, or if I'm going to make that triple spider spawner, or if I'm going to go into the the spawn area and make my spawn home or fountain or whatever I'm gonna do. But I'm pretty sure this is gonna be it for the episode. I really wanted to finish that building, but there has been close to 20 hours of playing time for this episode and helping other people with it. So I'm just going to go, and we'll finish this another time. So let me just throw my stuff away. I need to go get some diamond armor also. But let's do it with the thing. I have some spruce things because I was donating some wood for somebody, and that took a couple hours of my time also. But, I mean, you're on a server. You need to help people. It's the right thing to do. Video is second. Help people is first. So if you do play on the server and you need some help from me, let me know, because I don't mind helping. And next week, hopefully we'll finish that, or we'll make another couple of spider spawners for that triple thing and start taking out all the blocks. I do need to do some major mining, because since I've spoken to you last, I'm not the leader in the diamond quest. Not anymore. But have a good day. It's Keith for KMA's Korner. Enjoy the moonrise. And I will see you next time. Goodbye.